Okay, for this question, the domain is n element of z plus. What is z plus?
Z. Is that a z?
Yeah, that's a z. Z la.
Do they mean integers? Integer? I don't know what does a z mean.
It means integers, you're right. Then what does the plus mean?
Positive yes. Integers. Oh, I guessed it correctly.
So, are you currently doing the question now or what?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. N is an element of all positive integers. This means positive integers. Okay.
And the thing is what again?
Which one?
The middle.
Okay. Let me explain this whole thing to you. Okay. This basically means N is an element. Of. This is an element of symbolizes this E. Then of all positive integers is Z plus.
Okay.
So all positive integers means it starts from 1.
It starts from 1.
Correct.
Wait, is 0 is not
no.
positive? Right. It's not the summation thing, Kenny, is like binomial, right?
Binomial.
Yeah, it's like basically the whole bracket, n r bracket, right?
No, this means summation. This thing here means summation. Okay, what this means is, okay, see, we, lower limit is r equals 1, upper limit is n. Means it will be, you will have to include all r terms from 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to n. Okay, so which means the first term will be 4 times 1 minus 6. That's the first term. Second term will be 4 times 2 minus 6. Sorry. Then 4 times 3 minus 6. So on and so forth until 4 times n minus 6.
Oh, okay.
Get it?
Yeah.
That's what it means.
Okay, done. Can I take a picture and send you?
Yes, please. Okay, let me pull it out. Okay. How's your Good Friday?
I watched like the sermon online.
Oh, you guys like, you guys are Christians, huh?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, then what about step three?
Step three will be...
Okay, carry on with step three and four first.
Step three is stated as, is assuming that n equals k is true, right?
Assume that n equals k is true, correct.
Kenny, can I send it to you? I finished step.
Yes, please.
I don't know whether it's correct or not. Is it correct?
What you should be stating, right, for this for this area. Okay, it should be because look at this. This was the former equation, right? We have an N here. Sorry about the symbol. What you should be writing is like that. Okay, this is N. This R equals 1. 4R minus 6 equals to 2N. N minus 2. So from here, what we should be doing in step 3, okay, is to change all the N in the original equation to K. So what should become of this should be, when you put the IE, so the IE, it should be K 4R minus 6 equals to 2K times K minus 2. Get it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. Got it. Wait, but also it can be 4k minus 6, right?
No.
Huh? No.
No. You said that n equals to k. You didn't say r equals to k.
But doesn't n equal to r?
No. That is only one of the terms.
Oh.
That was the last term, right? Yeah. Because you're going to have like 4 times 1 minus 6, 4 times 2 minus 6. Until all the way to 4 times k minus 6. You're going to add all these terms up.
Oh, so the reason why for step 2, r also is 1 is because that's the only, that's the first term.
That's the first term, correct. Correct, you got it.
Okay then. Okay, done.
Okay, so once you're done with step 3, you can move on to step 4. How's it going?
I don't know how to do.
Oh, should have told me.
No, I was thinking of how to do it.
Oh, okay, okay. I understand that feeling. It's like you just want to solve it on your own. Okay, why not I go through with you first?
Using step three is summation of k, r equals to 1 for r minus 6. So I thought you use 2k bracket k minus 2.
Okay, come. Okay, I will start from step 3 because I don't want to write step 1 and step 2 already. Can I?
Yeah.
Okay, so step 3, the assumption would be this. R equals to 1 k 4r minus 6 equals to 2 k k minus 2. Okay, so in step 4, okay, we want to prove that this is true. R equals to 1, k plus 1, right? Then 4r minus 6 is equals to 2k plus 1, k plus 1 minus 2, which is also equivalent to 2. K plus 1, K minus 1. Make sense to you?
Well, it's what I got.
Yeah. So this is we have to prove from the left hand side to the right hand side, of course. Right? Okay. Mm-hmm. So when we prove from the left hand side to the right hand side, what we have to do here is that, remember, in step three, I always tell you in the previous lesson that we have to prove step four using the assumption in step three. Remember this? We have to prove step four using the assumption in step three.
Yeah.
So right now we have to prove from left hand side to right hand side. So we have to think about how can we convert the expression, okay? How can we convert the expression right here to make it look like it is in step three? Okay, I'll show you. I'll show you. So from here, left hand side would have been this, right? Okay, I think I write here, okay, because if not, at the bottom there's something blocking it. Okay, so left hand side is equals to k plus 1, right? Then here is 4r minus 6. Okay. Hello?
Yeah.
Okay. So from here, I want to convert to this. Can you see this part? Can you see what I'm circling?
Yeah.
I want the top part to be K. Okay. So this one, firstly, you have to know what does this mean. This means 4 times 1 minus 6, 4 times 2 minus 6, all the way to 4 times, I said it's plus, it's plus. Plus, plus, plus. Dot, dot, dot. Plus. Plus 4 times k minus 6 plus, the last one will be 4 times k plus 1 minus 6. Agree? This whole thing here basically means this. 4 times 1 minus 6. This is one term.
Yeah.
Plus yes. 4 times 2
yeah.
minus 6. This is another term. Yes. Plus all the way to 4 times k minus 6. This is the second last term. Then the last term will be plus 4 times k minus 1 minus 6. This is the last term. Hey, sorry, plus. 4 times k plus 1 minus 6. Understand?
Yeah.
This means this, but the thing is, you don't have to write this down. What I'm trying to tell you is that from here to here, excluding this, this part that I have charactered, right, that I have bracketed, right, it is actually summation of R equals to 1 to K 4 R minus 6. Take some time to digest.
Okay. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, I understand. Can I try and do myself?
Can. Always welcome to. Always welcome to. So just now, whenever I do MI questions, right, when I reach step 4, right, I always want to ask myself, how can I convert the expression to something like step 3? How can I convert the expression to step 3 so I can use the given result in step 3? This is what I want to ask myself. Yeah. So right now, we have confidently and successfully converted to something in step 3 really. So after that is how you want to use it. Okay? Can go and try. Then let me know. Okay?
Yeah, I got it.
That's not how you prove. Expression is totally wrong.
What?
The expression, how you present your answer is totally wrong.
Wait, how do I prove it then?
You should always prove from left-hand side to right-hand side. You shouldn't be writing the whole equation down.
Oh. Okay. Yeah.
Send me.
With my phone auto-updated itself, so I can't use it now.
Okay, never mind. I will just go through over here. So,
but I wrote the left hand side equals something, then right hand side equals to the 2k plus 1k minus 1. Then after I wrote, since LHS equals the right hand side, therefore Pn is true for n equals k plus 1.
Okay, but let me just write down the correct answer so that when you rewatch the video and you want to refer, then it's more convenient for you.
Okay.
Okay, so over here, just now as we have, as I have expanded the summation out for you, we know that we could have gotten, we can split this up to give us this, plus the k plus 1 term, right?
Yeah.
And the k plus 1 term in this scenario would be, okay, sorry, let's do this summation first. So from this summation, we know that from step 3, this would have become 2k times k minus 2. K plus 1 term will be 4 times k plus 1 minus 6. So over here, all we got to do is just to expand, right? So we get a 2k square minus 4k plus 4k plus 4 minus 6.
Equals to 2k square minus 2.
From here, we can take out 2. We can get k square minus 1. After that, k square minus 1 is equals to k plus 1. K minus 1.
1.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which is equals to right hand side.
So, instead of doing that, I wrote left hand side up to 2k square minus 2. Then for the right hand side, I made it become 2k square minus 2. So is that okay?
It's fine, but this way would have been better. It'll be cleaner. You don't have to manipulate both sides.
Yeah, I think I'll redo it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, can.
Okay. Then after that, it's the same conclusion and all. You know, just follow your school's template. Just memorize it.
Yeah.
Yeah. After that, from here, this is the last setup. And we are done for this. So, let's move on to your school's notes first. I want to go through your school's notes to explain to you first. Because I know it's very chunky, it's very wordy, and you don't really get it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so right now, you want to take 5 first before we come back?
Okay.
Yeah, we take 5 first because now we are going moving on to something new. I want to refresh our brain first.
Can I also get my lunch from downstairs?
Oh, yes, please go ahead. Then you want to take 10?
Okay.
You take 10. Yeah. I'll see you back at 1:57.
Okay.
Okay.
Hi, Kenny, I'm done. I'm back.
Yo, man.
Yeah, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Okay.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, so we are doing number two.
Yes, number two. So I'm gonna explain. Okay, direct proof, very simple. It's just LHS equals RHS. There's nothing much to it. Okay. But for proof by contra-positive, this one we have to understand what this is trying to say. Okay. Have you read this part yet? Have you read it yet?
I read, but I gave up halfway because it was too complicated for me to understand.
Okay. So over here, let's say, you can see where I'm pointing at, right?
Yeah. Is this the university syllabus one?
This is something that I learned in university. Back then, your seniors, right? Your seniors in ACSI, right? When I taught them, right? There wasn't this thing. 100%. No, a lot of things are not inside.
You get 7 points for HL Math.
Maybe, yeah. Like, all these things are not inside. That's why I'm damn shocked. Like,
yeah, then the syllabus also become harder. Like, there's a paper three this year.
Correct. So basically, right, any math tutor, who are out there, right, who did not take a math degree, right, will not be able to teach this. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
Because this is a uni thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway, many mathematical statements take the form of if this, then this, right? Like, you know, like if this happens, then that will happen. If you go to school, then you will not get detention or something like that.
Okay.
You know? Something like cause and effect, basically. Cause and effect, right? Okay, so for example, if b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, okay, so whenever someone tells you b squared minus 4ac is more than 0, means that there are two real and distinct roots, right? You still remember what Mr. E taught you or not?
Oh, yeah, yes.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
Remember? So if b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, means that the equation has two real and distinct roots. Then it has two real and distinct roots. So if the contra-positive means the opposite. Okay.
Yeah.
The opposite. If you want to translate it into something less chim, right? Something less profound, right? You'll be the opposite. Okay. So the opposite of an if P then Q is actually if not Q, then not P.
What? Wait. Actually, what does contra-positive, the word, mean? Is it like...
Means opposite.
Opposite.
Yeah. If you want to put it simply, it's just opposite. Okay, so let's say, for instance, we use a real-life scenario. Okay, something that must be very exclusive. The cause and effect, very exclusive. Can you come up? Do you have an example? Like something that's very, very exclusive.
A country club membership.
No. As in like a cause and effect. Okay. Let's say for instance, we talk about keyboard. Okay, we talk about keyboard right now.
Uh huh.
You see, now I'm going to press, my finger onto the button A. Okay? You see A, right? Do you see A?
Yeah.
You see A, right? Okay, I'm going to press it again. If I press on A, then the A will appear, right?
Mm.
Okay? So, if I press on A, then the A will appear.
Okay.
Yeah. So over here, what we understand is that Sorry. I'll move this apart first.
Okay.
Oh my god. Okay. This is the cost. This is the
effect.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So now the contra-positive. Okay, the contra-positive will be this. So over here you can see, right, that they say the contra-positive is if not Q, then not P. If not Q, then not P. Q is the effect. If not the effect, then not the cost. Okay, means if this effect, what is trying to say here is that if this effect does not happen, then it is not caused by this cost. Okay, or rather, if this effect does not happen, then this cost did not happen. I think this will be a better way of phrasing it. Take some time to digest.
If this effect does not happen, then this cause did not happen.
So in other words, if I want to do a translation, if the A did not appear, then I did not press on the A.
Oh. It's a bit of a common sense thing.
It's a bit of a common sense, right? But the thing is, it really takes a bit of time to digest the contra-positive.
It's like saying that if this does not happen, it does not happen.
Yeah. You have to go the opposite way for contra-positive.
What? Wait, what? Oh, so you have to reverse this whole thing.
Yes, you must say that if this doesn't happen, then this did not happen.
What? So if A will appear, then I press on A.
Yeah. If A appear means I press on A. But contra-positive means, right, if A never appear means I never press on A. That is what contra-positive means.
Oh.
Contra-positive is not if A appear, then I press on A. No, that is not contra-positive.
But how do you use this to prove?
Yeah. So no, that's why now I'm using a real life example to explain to you first before we move to the mathematical way of proving.
Okay.
Okay. So take one more minute to digest the contra-positive of this statement first. If I press on A, then the A will appear. So the contra-positive will be the opposite way. So we have talked about the effect first. If the effect didn't happen, means the cause didn't happen.
Yeah. Oh yeah, okay.
Yeah. I mean, in school, they don't have the time to really explain to you in this way, because right, they have lesser plan to follow. They are catering to 20, 30 over students.
My teacher talks at times 10 YouTube speed.
Serious? She's about Amor. Yeah.
She talks so fast until, I don't know.
Is that what Amor?
No.
It's local.
Local Chinese.
Then how does he or she talk so fast?
She talks super fast. Then she skim through this whole thing really fast.
I see. Yeah, but up to this point, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Okay, let's proceed.
Okay.
You can see my spotlight, right?
Yeah, the red thing.
Yes, very good. Oh, by the way, do you know they banned Zoom?
Huh?
Oh, you didn't know?
Why they ban Zoom?
MOE don't allow Zoom anymore because of the there's this sexual harassment case. You should go and Google it up, then you will know. Maybe later lah.
But still can use Zoom now, right? That can don't care about the rule, right?
As in like they ban for your MOE for your school
Or anyways, like, my school does not even use Zoom.
Oh.
We everything used on Microsoft Teams.
Oh.
Yeah. So we Teams video call everything on the same app. So it's like very useful. Okay. Multi-purpose. Yeah.
Cool. Okay. Let's come back to this.
Okay.
So in many cases, okay, so over here they have an example. Okay, but I think my example will be more fluid. Okay. But let's look at this example. If the quadratic equation ax squared plus bx does not have any real distinct roots, then b squared minus 4ac is lesser or equals to zero. So we can see here that, let me draw. That this here, it is the effect that did not happen. Okay, and this is the cause that did not happen. Can you see? Previously, it was this, it was the cause first. If the cause happened, then the effect happened. But now, we want to say that the effect did not happen for contra-positive.
So it's always effect first, in a way.
Yes, you must tell them that the effect did not happen. So if the effect did not happen, then the cause did not happen.
Wait, I annotate my book first.
Sure. Sorry, you think give me 1 minute.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So I want you to notice that they did change something. Okay, what did they change? As you can see, the cause was previously, can you see what I highlight?
Yeah.
The cause was previously b squared minus 4ac greater than zero. But now in contra-positive, they are mentioning that the cause did not happen. Means you need to mention that the opposite of the cause, which is b squared minus 4ac lesser or equals to zero.
Okay.
Do you identify that? Do you see that they change a bit?
Yeah, they did, right?
Because you see, previously I also mentioned if I press on A, that was the cause. But now when I want to mention that the cause did not happen, we have to mention the opposite of the cause, which is I did not press on A.
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Mm.
So it's always effect first then cause.
Yeah, you have to mention that effect did not happen. So what does contra-positive, this is a proving by contra-positive. So what does this actually mean? So the thing is, sometimes it's difficult to prove this. Okay. The question wants you to prove this, okay? But the thing is, let's say if you cannot prove this, you cannot prove that the if this happened, then this happened, then you have to prove the contra-positive. You have to prove the opposite. By proving the opposite, right, when this thing leads to this thing, you are actually proving the original statement. You understand what I'm trying to say? By proving the contra or the opposite statement, right? By proving the opposite statement to be true, the original statement will be true. Get it?
No, I don't. Wait. By proving the opposite statement to be true.
The original statement will be true. The original statement meaning this one.
Okay.
Because if you think about it, if I press on A, then the A will appear. On the contrary, if the A did not appear, then I did not press on A. It means the same thing, what? Make sense?
Oh.
You look at the two statements. If I press on A, then the A will appear. If the A did not appear, then I did not press on A. Isn't it the same thing?
Yeah, but what's the point of the sentence being rearranged?
Okay, what's the point? Because you cannot prove this. They want you to prove by contra. They want you to prove by contra positive. Like, okay, so now,
Kenny.
Yeah.
So is it because the question will not give you the orange, the one you circled orange, this part, for example, like the
which
question
one?
Will give it to you.
Which one?
But the question will give you the front part.
Which one? I don't know.
Okay, I draw. Annotate. This one. So does it mean that the question will not give you this one? You need to find
yes.
this one.
Yes, correct. You need to show this so that you can prove this.
Oh.
Yeah, the question wants you to
oh.
do that. The question wants
wait,
you to Yeah,
oh.
because sometimes it's difficult to prove from the original statement. Like, if I press on A, how are you going to prove that I press on A?
Oh, yeah.
Right?
So it's because they will not give you this, for example, this part, and then they will probably give you this part here. And
sorry,
you
I'm sorry.
Need to use this logic to prove this in order to prove this whole thing.
Again?
You need to use this contra-positive logic, this
mm-hmm.
this concept for it to be proven.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I understand the logic already.
Yeah. That's what I mean by proving the opposite statement to be true, the original statement will be true.
Okay, I get it. I get this part.
Can I? Okay, let me clear this thing up.
Okay, just curious, will calculus in this HL syllabus be very hard also?
You want the honest answer is that I think everything is going to be hard.
Oh.
It's just a matter of like previously you will feel that mathematical induction is quite tough, right? But right now after you understood it,
it's okay.
It's okay.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of
practicing more in your
practice, yeah. Or rather like the initial phase, the kind of guidance that you can get, like, is the person able to clarify your, once you are able to get your doubts clarified, then everything will be simple.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, you cannot stop your teacher from explaining fast because, like, she's catering to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that is also the reason why you came to me, because I can cater to your pace. We can go a bit slower. Yeah. But I don't see how much faster your teacher can, is that, if she go any faster than how I teach right here, is too fast already. It's also because you won't be able to understand properly. Yeah, but this place is okay, right?
That is a good place.
Okay, great. So now you understand what I mean by this. We have to prove the opposite one to show the original one. Okay, so now...
Penny, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can. I can.
The Zoom just sent me a notification saying that I have to relaunch Zoom because the audio service on my comm is not responding.
But you can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you and you can hear me, right?
Then doesn't matter because... Okay. Then we just stick to this because we don't really have much time left. Maybe tomorrow we can start a bit earlier.
Sunday, you mean?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Sunday, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sunday can start like 10 o'clock. Wait. Yeah, 10. 10 to 1.
I can only do... Earliest I can do is 10:30.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Can Okay. Yeah. Right now. Prove that if x squared is, can you see this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Prove that if x squared is even, then x is even. So what we have to prove, the contra-positive. So what's the contra-positive? The
contra-positive. Which is a cause and effect. I need to identify which is the. Yeah.
Okay. Which is the cause? This is the cause, isn't it? And then this is the effect.
How do you identify which is the cause, which is the effect?
Cause always is first.
Oh.
If so this, then this one. If this, if you don't study, then you are going to fail. Which one is the cause?
Don't study.
Yeah, lah. Because cause always happens first, right? It cannot be the effect cannot affect the cause, but the cause can affect the effect.
Yeah. But if x is even, x can also be even.
Don't think about that. You're not supposed to think about the original statement.
Oh.
You're supposed to think about the contra-positive statement. So this is where you will go very wrong. This is where you will not ever understand contra-positive. Because you're thinking about, hey, how to prove this statement that they give me. Don't think about that. You're supposed to prove by contra-positive. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we are supposed to find out the contra-positive statement, which is if we have to say if the effect did not happen, which is if X is not even, okay, then X square is not even. In other words, if it's not even means what? It's odd, right? Make sense? Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah. So over here we can say that if x is odd, then x square is odd.
If x is odd, then x square is odd. If x is odd.
This is the contra-positive.
Oh. So, Kenny, so the question will always give you in a way that the cause and effect, it will be cause and effect first. Then, when you answer the question, you must swap it around.
Yes, you must prove the contra-positive. The not effect, not cause. If not effect, then not cause.
Oh. Wait, can I jot it down somewhere?
Go ahead.
The theory, like the question. So it's if not effect, then not cause.
Yeah. Okay. If not effect, then not cause. That is what you are supposed to prove.
Okay. Get it. Got it already.
Okay. So, over here, this is what we have to prove right here, which is this.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, let's look at your school's notes. See what they did. Okay, so you yourself, you also wrote it. Prove that if x squared is even, then x is even. If x is not even, then x squared is not even.
No, I call you from my teacher.
Yeah, correct. Because your teacher wrote down the contra-positive statement. So we are supposed to prove this contra-positive statement. But if we simplify, we go and process this statement a little bit more. Actually, what we are trying to show is that if x is odd, then x squared is odd. Which is what we have here.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, so now then after that, what your teacher did is she went on to prove it already, because they say that if x is odd, whenever you say if something, if x is odd, means we are trying to assume that this thing is what it is, right?
Yeah.
So we suppose, okay, always use the word suppose x is odd.
Okay.
Okay. So x is equals to 2k plus 1.
Wait, what? How do we know that?
Because for any value, for any number of, for any integer value of k,
the 2 will be the even. Then you plus 1 will be odd.
Yeah.
Why not minus 1? Just curious.
Also
minus
can. Also can. Up to you.
Okay.
Up to you. Also can. Okay. So after that, so suppose that x is odd, so we know that x is equals to 2k plus 1.
Yeah.
We get that. Okay, the reason why mathematicians don't like to use 2k minus 1 is because there are a few things that mathematicians don't like. We don't like decimals, they don't like fractions, they don't like negative numbers.
Oh.
Because negative times negative gives you positive. It's damn mafan. It's like you might make a careless mistakes from there.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so we always want to only deal with positive side, because positive and positive always positive, it's just positive. If you're positive all the way, you're positive all the way, right?
Yeah.
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 You get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, because it's like an additional step.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we should always be positive.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. We get that x square. So now we need to prove that is that is the x square is odd, right?
Yeah.
Can you see where I'm circling?
Yeah,
we need to prove that x square is odd. Now that we already know x is 2k plus 1. That's why after that, x square will be equals to 2k plus 1 square. Okay. So by manipulating, by expanding this, we will get 4k squared plus 4k plus 1.
Wait, so you write 2, so the first step is to form the statement, the second step is to write x equals 2k plus 1 second, then you just sub in 2k plus 1 into the x and square root equal, and you expand it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, then after which, what happened is that they factorize. They want to make this thing 4k square plus 4k, I'm at the top of the screen, plus 1. Yeah. Okay. They want to show that this one it becomes a positive number. So how to make this a positive number? They want to make this an odd number. Okay, how do we show that it's an odd number? As long as it's an even number plus 1, it will be an odd number, right?
Yeah.
Make sense? Any even number you plus 1, 100% you'll be odd. You find me one even number where you plus 1 and it's not odd. I give you $50 cash.
Yeah.
Don't have, right? Yeah, so I can save some money. So. So from here, we want to isolate this plus 1 over here, because we know that, we want to isolate this plus 1 over here. because we know that this plus one is going to make any even number odd.
Yeah.
Makes sense, right? Okay.
So we isolate it.
Yes. So we don't really touch the plus one. We just need to prove that this part here is even. Make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how to show that this part 4k squared plus 4k, how do we show that it's even?
Do you factorize the 4 out because 4 is an even number?
Okay, usually you are right. But I mean usually we don't use 4, we'll use
2.
2, very good. So over here what we want to do is we'll take out 2 instead. So when we took out 2 from the 4k squared plus 4k, we'll get 2 times 2k squared plus 2k. Correct?
Yeah.
Plus 1.
Which is odd.
Yeah, because whatever this number is over here, it doesn't matter anymore. If it's even, I times 2, I will get even number. If it's odd, I times 2, I also get even number.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, right? So this whole chunk here is bound to be even already. Make sense to you?
Yeah.
So once this whole chunk here is even, I add to the 1, I'm going to get an odd number. So there was no need for your school to express it in this format. Like, this is very complicated. There's no need for them to do this. You understand?
Yeah.
Yeah. And therefore, we can show that x squared is odd.
Wait, can I rewrite the cancelled part?
You understand what I'm explaining, right?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so our objective is met really. We prove that we suppose that x is odd by using 2k plus 1. Then we substitute the 2k plus 1 into the x square, into the x in x square. Then we prove that the x square is odd. After we prove that the x square is odd, means this whole statement here is true. So if this whole statement here is true, then we can say that this statement here on the right hand side, x squared, if x squared is even, then x is even, is true.
Yeah.
Then the whole problem is solved.
Oh.
I hope you understand this a bit better.
That's okay. Well, actually, it's not that hard.
It's okay, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, you see, if students find it easy, right, I will go out of business.
Yeah.
Yeah. So thank God that students still find it hard. But sorry, I don't mean to be sadistic, but I mean, we are here to help each other, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Ethan, I have to attend to another student. This whole session is recorded. After that, I'll upload, then I'll share with you. If you ever forget about contra-positive again, you can come back to review this video.
Okay, okay.
Can
so, Sunday will...
10:30.
They can end at 1:30.
Cannot, because 1 o'clock, I got another lesson.
Oh.
Never mind, next week, you can do more lessons.
Yeah, okay.
Can I?
Yeah.
Okay, I will see you on Sunday.
So we can need to finish this whole thing on Sunday.
Yeah, you can up. Yeah, correct. You can try so in your tutorial, right, in your assignments, right, you can go and try your mathematical induction questions and contra-positive questions as well as direct proofs.
Yeah.
Okay. For the proof by contradiction and disproving a statement by counterexample on the bottom left here, right? The part 3 and part 4, maybe you don't touch first.
Okay.
Yeah. 1, 2, and 5, you are ready.
Okay.
3 and 4, don't touch first.
Okay.
Can?
Can.
Okay, sorry, 1 minute. Let me screenshot this and send you first. Okay. Okay, so if not, enjoy your Good Friday and just chill.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye.